programının sıçmalarıdır. Hatha Yoga gives us kriyas, mudras, mantras, which are not there in Patanjali Yoga. It gives the names of the asanas, pranayama, and others, which are also not found in Patanjali. In Patanjali Yoga Sutras, we get the principle, and the details are not given. In Hatha Yoga, by Swatmarama, the details have been given. The different postures, the names of the postures, pranayama and others. The new dimensions that are added on are the mudras, bandhas and kriyas. Kriyas particularly, the shat kriyas, the six cleansing techniques which help to cleanse the inner portions of our body have been brought forth very effectively. And then we have the advanced techniques called the mudras, the bandhas. I was telling you the other day that when you have to practice the pranayama, the Hatha Yoga way, Kumbhaka, we practice. Then the bandhas are must, the Jalandhara Bandha, the Uddiyana Bandha, the Moola Bandha. And without the bandhas, if you practice pranayama with Kumbhaka, you are in for danger. You may get neurotic, you may become mad, you may lose all your memory, you may lose your creativity, and you may get depressed, and all types of mental problems can come up. Therefore, it is very, very necessary to see that you perfect the bandhas before you do the Kumbhaka pranayama. Therefore, what we have adopted here is the Vasishta school, in which there is no forceful holding of the breath. It is to promote the Kevala Kumbhaka, and the slowing of the breath is achieved by slow inhalation and slow exhalation. In Hatha Yoga, you have the normal inhalation, hold the breath. Normal exhalation, hold the breath. So holding the breath helps you to slow down the number of breaths per minute in Hatha Yoga. Whereas in the Vasishta Yoga, we have the slow inhalation, slow exhalation. At the end of inhalation, you can notice the breath turns, then the breath stops automatically. After inhalation, before exhalation, it stops. That is the effortless stopping that takes place. It's called Kevala Kumbhaka. Similarly, when you exhale, at the end of exhalation, automatically the breath turns over. There the breath stops. There it comes up. That is again Kevala. So this Kevala Kumbhaka should be increased. So the objective of pranayama is to have this Kevala Kumbhaka elongated. By so doing, you get number of benefits. Very powerful benefits compared to yogic postures. It is said that if you practice 1 hour of asana, 1 hour of pranayama, which is better? 1 hour pranayama is 10 times more effective than 1 hour of asana, it is said. So pranayama is very, very essential. But what is the purpose of doing the pranayama? Gain mastery of the mind. Yogaha Chitta Vritti Nirodha Patanjali Seva. The same is it. So Hatha Yoga prepares us to go to the Raja Yoga and the Patanjali Yoga. Another great contribution of Patanjali is the calming of the mind, silencing of the mind, getting to samadhi and the highest stages of samadhi. Eight types of samadhi reaching the ultimate goal, that is the Kaivalya chakra. Whereas in Hatha Yoga, the new dimension is added, that is the Kundalini. In Patanjali, Kundalini has not been mentioned. The Ida and the Pingala nadis are not mentioned. The Sushumna are not mentioned. No? And this is the new dimension added on in the Hatha Yoga. So, what are these nadis? As I have mentioned, they are the main things in our pranamaya portion. They are channels of prana in the pranamaya portion. There are a long number of nadis which make the pranamaya portion. Just like in the physical body, you have the blood vessels, you have the nerves. Similarly, the pranamaya portion has a big network of nadis. How many nadis? 7 to 12 lakh nadis. And even more according to the Hatha Yoga. When you have prana flowing through all these nadis, you have the sensation of touch that comes. But among all these 72 lakh nadis, there are three main nadis, three main channels of prana. One is the Chandra nadi, another is the Surya nadi, and there is a Sushumna nadi. Sun, moon, Ida, Pingala, Chandra, Surya, then the Sushumna. And what is the concept of Kundalini? Kundalini is a subtle form of prana. Normally, the prana flows through Ida and Pingala in all of us. And in all of us, the Sushumna is not opened up. When there is proper balance between the two nadis and the breath slows down and becomes very small, almost stopping, then the Sushumna opens up. What happens in the process of opening of the Sushumna? There is a transformation of the gross pranashakti into the subtle pranashakti. Kundalini is something that is special, transformed, subtle prana. And therefore, it is very, very subtle and very powerful. And Kundalini, once you start coming up with Sushumna, the first thing that happens is the first chakra, Muladhara chakra, that opens up. Then it starts coming up. Once it comes up, it will not go to the head. It will go up and start there, the next chakra, Muladhara Swadhisthana. And you have to go on purifying it further. Still slow the breath, balance the breath, and see that you control all the food and other things. And gradually then what happens? The second chakra opens. Swadhisthana, Manipura. Like that one by one, chakras come up. And once you come to the Agna chakra, that's here, then it goes to the final and the Sahasrara, the thousand petaled chakra opens up. That means there is huge expansion that takes place. That is samadhi. In samadhi we see that there is expansion. Similarly, in Sahasrara when it opens up, you are in that great samadhi. And that is what Patanjali says, samadhi. So, the technique that has been talked about in Hatha Yoga is opening up of the Sushumna, the Brahmarantra, it's called. And the prana in the form of Kundalini start going up and up to the ultimate. But many people, if they do not obey the laws and the do's and don'ts prescribed by Satmarama and try to awaken the Kundalini, again you get devastated. Unfortunately, what happened is that there are some people, great gurus, who opened up the Sushumna in a large number of people. I remember in those days, Swami Muktanandi in Maharashtra. So, large number of people, he used to open up the Kundalini. Very special thing, Shaktipada. In Maharashtra, they organized Sampradaya and Shaktipada. They will give that and the Kundalini will get opened up. As a result of that, people like Shri will get wonderful results. They feel very good, good memory, good creativity, lightness, and brilliance, and balance, and everything comes. And soon they start getting completely distraught. They become mad, or they get neurotic, and they can get all types of problems. Then they start shaking the whole body, and whenever they have problems. Therefore, what happened at that time? I think it's around 70s, 73, 74, 75, around those years. Everywhere, people got fascinated to go into the Shakti path and start opening up their kundalini without proper adherence to the prescribed do's and don'ts by Swatmarama. And as a result, they started getting into problems. Thousands and thousands of people, they all got into problems. So how to remedy them? They all went to Swamiji. Muktanandi, now we have this problem, we have this problem, now we have awakened our kundalini, then we have to remedy that. He had no solution. So what to do? All number of the shishyas and students, they called for those experts who can deal with the things and solve the problems. So many people came forward and they called them as spiritual emergency clinics. Spiritual emergency clinic. Just like in medical we have, they are called as spiritual emergency clinic. At that time it used to be in Kanyakumari and lot of people started coming there. And we have the remedy for those things to do that. Because everything is there. Only thing is you have to pick it up and then apply that. And people started getting better. So, what are those specified things that are there to be done? Is Kumbhaka is done properly, and slowing of breath should happen properly, and balance of breath should start coming to happen properly. These are all the things that he had done. Particularly the food is very important. You cannot take the normal food. You have to have the controlled food that has been prescribed by this thing. So, these are all things that happen. So, how to awaken the kundalini is the Shakti path. But what is the traditional approach for doing that? So, Rupanishtha Margena, Kundalini Jagrato Bhavet, by the proper direction by the teacher. Teacher will prepare you to see that the kundalini start coming up. Kundalini is like a very high power thing. Suppose you have a small thin wire and you put 5000 volts into that electricity. The wire will burn. Similarly, Kundalini is very, very, very powerful. If you allow that to come up without proper preparation, without making your conductor capable of taking that electric power, it will burn. Therefore, first you have to see that your capacity to forego the Kundalini will start coming up. Proper diet, simple diet, and limited diet, very important. Then the body should be prepared by doing proper pranayama and do this thing. Then you awaken the Kundalini. The teacher should take care of the students. And if they are erring somewhere, then they will correct it. That's how one-to-one correspondence of the teacher with the student was very necessary. But if you don't do that, then you will be a danger. Now, in this chapter, the three things are the Mahamudra, Mahabandha, Mahaveda. These are the advanced techniques in Hatha Yoga, which the traditional teachers give them. And how to do that? They're all the advanced practices. So, for coming to the Mahamudra, Mahabandha, Mahaveda, you have to perfect the bandhas, mudras, and others. In these things, you have to work at the subtle level, the prana level. So, what is the one that happens in the mudra? Normal mudras, Kin mudra, Kinmay mudra, Adi mudra. So, what are the specialities of these mudras? The mudras should start operating at the prana level. You should be able to feel the prana. How to feel the prana? You have to increase your sensitivity level. to feed the prana. So in our pranic energization technique, PET, that we teach here, the advanced practices, you'll be able to feed the prana. So the prana has to be fed, and prana has to be moved, prana has to be controlled, and this is the reasons of operation of the mudras. If you simply keep here, nothing is going to happen. You have to feel the prana flowing through these things. Move the jhana into those directions. So this is a special technique that have been developed here for development, the advanced technique. So we have seven advanced techniques that have been developed in our university, and this works first at the body level, that is the avartan dhyana, cyclic meditation, at the prana level, that is the pranic energization technique, PET. Then we have got in the mind level, the manomaya kosha, we have got mind sound resonance technique, mind imagery technique, and mastering the emotions technique. Three practices at the manomaya kosha level. To work at the sound level, to work at the vision level, and work at the emotional level. Then the vijnanamaya kosha. We have got visara, vijnana, sadhana, kosha. And the last is the anandamaya kosha, anandamanta siddha, anus. So these are the seven techniques that have been developed. The CM, the PET, MSRT, MIRT, MEMT, Visara, and Anamas. And all these techniques work at the subtle level, at the deeper and deeper levels. And this can be done while sitting or lying down, and can be practiced by everybody. These techniques were developed in the context to deal with cancer patients. And cancer patients, even they are very, very severe, they cannot move from their bed also, they cannot turn. Some people also can do these practices. Every practice is about half an hour. If they have 1 week program in which they learn this technique and they start adopting it. Then in cancer what we do is we strengthen the immune system. And by strengthening the immune system, suppression goes away and the cancer starts coming up. As most of you know, in cancer, we have the cancer cells which are not coming from outside. The cancer cells are born in our body. In all our body, in a day, 1 billion cells get created, 1 billion cells get destroyed. Among the billion cells that are created, maybe 1,000 cells will not follow the laws of proper created cells. They are not in children. And they want to go away from the normal thing. And they want to behave in the abnormal. These are the cells. They do not follow the norms which are put for normal cells. And as a result, these cells are governed up and destroyed by our immune system. So that you have all healthy cells that are there. In all our bodies, therefore the cancer cells are born, but they are destroyed by our immune system. Just like the immune system takes care of all the millions of cells that come from outside, trying to hit us and kill us. That all are taken care of by our immune system. Immune system is a very strong defense that we have within us. So I will take it, therefore no cancer. But in cancer patients, something different happens. Somehow, the immune system thinks that this cancer are my good friends. One of the qualities of the immune system is to find out who is the enemy, who is the friend. If it is the enemy, it should destroy. If it is a friend, it should promote, naturally. Instead of it is a friend, it should promote. Cancer cells are enemies, therefore it has to be destroyed. But somehow the immune system gets confused and thinks, oh, these cancer cells are my good friends and do not destroy. So over weeks, months, and years, maybe 5 years, 10 years, 15 years, the number of cancer cells will grow bigger and bigger. And when they become big, that is malignancy, then it's diagnosed as cancer. So what do? We have chemotherapy, radiation, or surgery. In chemotherapy, use chemicals to destroy these cells, the cancer cells. In radiation, you have powerful X-rays or these things to see that these cancer cells are destroyed. Or when things are big, the tumors will be cut by the cell. These are the three ways which are there for cancer treatment. But this doesn't solve the problem. We have the surgery, and after some time, 1 year, 2 years, again, we start getting cancer in different parts of the body. Why? The root cause is not removed. What the root cause? Confusion of the immune system. Thinking that cancer cells are my good friends, you know. Unless you remove that confusion, you have no solution. That's why in modern medical system, we have no solution. Once you have cancer, it's for your lifetime, then your days are numbered, come to pass. So what does yoga say? You have to go to the root cause. What is the root cause? The immune system, which has got confused, had to be clarified. The avidya has to be removed. The wrong notion has to be removed. What is the wrong notion? Cancer cells are my good friends. That has to be removed. Question is, why does the immune system get confused? So it occurs because of the lifestyle, stressful lifestyle. When a lot of stress, then you get confused normally. You cannot have objectivity. You lose your objectivity. You lose your decision-making capacity because you are too much stressed out. You put several things. Same thing happens here. If you have too much of stress and a very stressful lifestyle and the wrong lifestyle, then the immune system gets confused. It is very well known that stress has an immunosuppressant factor. Immune system gets suppressed because of the external stress. So what is to be done therefore? That confusion has to be removed. You have to remove the stress. And how to remove the stress? By the pranayama. By bringing the balance. What is the feature of the stress? Stress is an imbalance. Stress is an imbalance at the body level, imbalance at the autonomic nervous system, imbalance at the brain level, imbalance at the endocrine level, so at the body level. But at the prana level, it is the imbalance of the prana, imbalance between the left and the right nostril, imbalance between the ida and the pingala. And at the mind level also is the imbalance. So at the prana level, you start bringing the balance, then you have a solution. How to bring the balance? Alternate nostril breathing. And Surya Bheda, Chandra Bheda, Nadi Shuddhi, Pranayama, which will help to bring the balance of breath between the two nostrils. And in pranic analysis technique, we work at the subtle level. We bring the balance between the ida and pingala at the subtle level. By recognizing that prana moving through the ida and the pingala dimension, you should feel and do this thing. So once you start doing that, what happens? Your immune system starts getting normalized. Its confusion goes away. And it starts gobbling up all the cancers. This is how cancer is treatable and have been treated. There are a lot of such people who have come to us who have become normal. People who were declared dead. I remember in 1986, there were six patients that were sent by the director of the Kidwa Memorial Institute of Oncology, Dr. Krishna Varga. They said, all these people have undergone radiation, chemotherapy, surgery, everything, and they are declared almost dead. We can't do anything more. We can give only painkillers. And probably in the liver, the 3 months, 4 months, 6 months maximum, they have told. But then he said, why don't you go to yoga? They came on to Dr. Nagaratna and they started taking up the yoga every day in Bangalore, in our clinic, in Chamarajpet, in Portland, where we have our clinic. And there they used to come 2.5 hours every day, 5 o'clock to 7:30. One hour of theory, 1 hour of practice, 30 minutes of interaction. We started doing that. Everybody started feeling good, very relaxed. And sacred meditation started giving them very deep rest. And as a result of that, they used to feel very light, very energetic. And at counseling, making them understand what is this cancer, how it occurs, what is the pathology, what pathophysiology we give them, and what are the techniques of yoga and others. And day by day they started improving. I remember on the 16th day, one of the ladies who had breast cancer, she was only 35 years. She was having the breast cancer. She had radiation, chemotherapy, surgery, everything done. It has spread throughout the body. Metastasis occurred. And she came and told Navratna, after doctor, I'm feeling so good now. Can I start going back to work? She had not gone to work for almost 5 years. She is a professor of mathematics. Navratna said, okay, go. But don't get shaky. Slowly build up. Initially, you start with 2 hours, 3 hours like this, and gradually you increase the number. And she started developing, and started developing. Dr. Vishnu Bhargava has told at that time, 1996, that you will not live more than 6 months. And even today, that lady is living. The bike is starting to normal. All of it happened. This is what you have. We have tremendous amount of power we have. We have to bring it up. We have to remove all the confusions. We have to see that the things start coming up. And all the 6 patients who came there, you know, they all started good. We had breast cancer, we had leukemia, and we had bone cancer. Bone cancer was the most severe. When he came, he could not move left or right, even while lying in the bed. Such severe things he used to have. But then he started doing the PET, you know, lying down. And slowly he started doing it. Within about 15 days, he was able to nicely move and sit up. And it was the first day he was able to stand. In 1 month and 10 days, 40 days, he started going back to work, you know, in the weekly work. So this is what yoga can do. Then we wanted to show that this is possible by systematic research. So far we have published nearly 24 research papers on cancer, in which we have shown the immune system blossoms. It is theory, okay, immune system is going to get normal. What a proof. So we measure all the immune parameters, cytokines and several other things, and shown that yes, when you start doing yoga, all these immune parameters will start developing. Then we went deeper to understand what happens in the DNA, DNA repair mechanisms. We measure what is happening to DNA. DNA repair starts improving better. Then we went to the deeper thing called apoptosis. Apoptosis is a programmed cell death. The programmed cell death is deteriorated in cancer because of the naughty cells. So apoptotic index started developing. And the deepest parameter is the purification factor called NF-kappa B. And we measured NF-kappa B, and in our country, we did not have the things to measure NF-kappa B. So in Hyderabad, our persons went and developed this entire thing and measured NF-kappa B, and we have shown even NF-kappa B will start improving. Therefore, we have been able to show that yoga works even in the cancer patient. Based on this, now we have taken up a big cancer control program throughout the country. This year, we are going to do, see that throughout the country, we have joined hands with the government, the Ministry of Health and Family Welfare, to set up a big center for prevention of cancer in the country. Our Prime Minister has given the mandate that yes, now we have controlled cancer. Last year he gave a mandate, control diabetes, with a big diabetes control program. This time we are going to have cancer control program. It's a big project that's coming up, and most of you are welcome to join hands to take up this. You have to get trained as to how to do that. Hatha Yoga, Padma Yoga, wonderful tools by which you should do that. So what you have to do, essentially principle is stress reduction, cyclic meditation, the pranayama, and advanced techniques, all these things can see that you alleviate. So this is a big project that is coming up throughout the country. In all the states, they are going to have, in 109 districts throughout the country, they are going to have, and they are going to screen about 1 crore people and find out how many people have cancer, what type of cancer they have, and the screening and build the awareness, and several dimensions we have planned out. So therefore, the entire dimension of Hatha Yoga, Patanjali Yoga, and others are not only to become practiced by a few people, it has got such applications to deal with modern NCDs. And that is what we are doing through the research and the scaling of our cancer. And we have been able to show this by small things like 30, 40, 50 people randomized control trials. Now we are developing the entire scale of model throughout the country we are taking up. So we have systematic training for you, for those people who want to volunteer to take part in this cancer. Yoga volunteers for cancer control. And it's a 6 hours program which you will learn and participate in the big movement. And I welcome all those who want to participate in the big national program to do that and see that you can go. Why I see, you can do. So let us contemplate on these thoughts. Sit tight with your eyes closed. Take a deep breath and slowly breathe out. Relax all parts of the body. Beautiful smile on the face. Also bring balance between the two nostrils. And the mind comes down. Stress is reduced. The whole body is full of energy, vitality. The mind becomes calm and quiet. You start experiencing the deep sense of happiness and bliss. Silence is bliss, bliss is peace, shanti. Spread the fragrance of the bliss and peace to everyone who we meet today by sharing, by giving, by dana. That is the way we have to change our lifestyle. Come to Namaskaram Dhyana.